once you have a good teacher, what he teaches is not really important. If he teaches me violin or being a history teacher, that's what I'm gonna learn. A good teacher fires that spark in you, and it fires really easily for me.
My name is Henrik Holmberg. I'm a decathlete. And as my ancestors used to say, a wise man should use his power with discretion.
The Athletes Village in Taipei. 12,000 students gathered for the Universiade, and they come from across the globe. From the Lone Star State of Texas, the Kingdom of Jordan, from Lusaka, all the way to Belgrade, and even a small town in Norway called Vik, the home of Henrik Holmberg.
It's always good, and then when so many young people meet, and it's always a lot of energy, and just in a dining hall, and people have their birthday, and everyone is cheering on them because it's their birthday, and the whole dining hall just lights up, you know, that's the kind of vibe that's here, and that's all, it's super fun to be a part of.
Days leading up to the start of competition are underpinned by a nervous tension, which only begins to lift when the athletes set foot in the bus to head to the opening ceremony. Henrik and his Norwegian teammates set off in the afternoon and wait in the holding area of Taipei Stadium until it's their time to enter. It's an emotional moment. It's his third and final Universiade, having completed in Kazan and Guangzhou. Taipei marks the last time he will walk with his fellow students.
Great atmosphere, and then just amongst athletes, it's a huge, it's just a spectacle. And even like the area we were waiting, like there, each nation was cheering for each other and doing these shouts and stuff. It was a lot of fun.
Henrik's chosen event is the decathlon. 10 events over 2 grueling days, comprising running, throwing, and jumping. In spite of the flight, he's happy with his build-up.
Is going really well. I had a really good long jump session and then shot put session as well. I've shaked out of jet lag in 2 days, which is a new record, and my body feels really good, so it's looking great.
Sibor Bjorton is Henrik's coach, but he isn't an expert in each of the 10 events, so Henrik is happy for a bit of advice from the specialist coaches that are on hand.
You've got 10 events and you don't have coaches for all of them, and then there are specialty coaches at each area you're practicing at. Old-timers, they know you're a decathlete, and then I'm like, I'm a decathlete, and then he says, of course you are. You put your elbow up and you'll do better, and that's how it is as a decathlete too, because most people are friendly with you.
It's a promising start to Henrik's bid to press for a medal in Taipei. But the Zen spirit of tranquility doesn't last long. Bureaucracy gets in the way. A carefully constructed training schedule is thrown into confusion when Henrik is told that he cannot practice discus. And then there are problems with the pole vault.
Worried, is always nervous when it comes to pole vaulting, but we didn't get the poles that we're going to compete with, and every pole is different. You got length, you got weight, and you got flexibility, so there are 3 components that makes it very hard to estimate how the pole will work. Getting a different now and maybe getting a different at the competition, it's just a lot of stress. We got 20 minutes left of pole vaulting, and that's it, that's the time we got. So 20 minutes and he haven't even jumped yet.
Well, it might not be so bad if the pole vault wasn't one of Henrik's weaker events, but in spite of setbacks, the 27-year-old business management master maintains an icy calm and pragmatism.
Of course you would like it to go smooth, but it never does, so you better just prepare for that and then do the best you can where you're at and make the best out of it, and then as a decathlete you always end up doing it like that.
His first Universiade came in Kazan in 2013. He finished ninth then, and 12th 2 years later in South Korea. Not the glory that the Ogashdana University graduate was looking for, but each Games did at least end in a personal best. While there may be dreams of climbing on the podium in Taipei, the reality may lie simply in continuing improvement.
For Henrik, the most important thing is just to have a good competition after an injury, finding a flow and actually start thinking about next season. But definitely, if it all goes in, and we hope it do, it might just go all the way.
Medal or not, one thing is certain, Henrik will continue as an athlete with even bigger dreams.